Tonight we are have a great pleasure to be able to showcase one of the world's great thinkers at innovation, Professor Dan Levinthal. This is, of course, made all possible by Michael J. Crouch, who is a very generous philanthropist for the school, who's made this possible. He's very passionate about innovation, as in fact a sponsored chair in innovation, and allowed us to bring people like Dan here this evening.
I looked up Dan on Google Scholar today. Dan actually has four or five publications in the multi-thousands on Google Scholars, which makes him one of the most influential management and strategy academics out there, which makes him a fantastic recipient of the Michael J. Crouch Fellowship in Innovation. He also holds the most distinguished chair at Wharton in this area, the Reginald H. Jones Professorship of Corporate Strategy at Wharton. I can't think about a more important or prescient topic than the one that Dan's going to talk about this evening. Dan Levinthal.
As I know, there's a few basic elements there why this need for adaptation. First, even if the world didn't change, your problem as a business manager is incredibly hard. Right? And to give a little perspective, think about the game of chess. That is trivial compared to the game of management, right? We have well-established pieces, they have authorized moves, we're together on this little board, there's no stochastic element. It's taken IBM until a year or two ago to beat a human being, an expert human being. But you think about it, you know, this is a dynamic programming problem. We ought to know what the optimal solution is. You can't, with modern computer technology, say what the optimal solution is in this very trivial game. Why would you begin to imagine that somebody could follow the problem of how to run one of your enterprises? So a little bit of perspective that, you know, inherently, you're unlikely in any given instant to have it at some ideal state. There are going to be opportunities for improvement and change.
Well, I think some of the key takeaways are around the balance between exploring and exploiting. And Dan raised the critical issue that there's a lot of bias that comes in with firms exploiting. They're almost self-selecting the type of decisions, self-selecting the type of outcomes by a heavy bias on exploiting. Where he talked about having the right balance between exploration, where you're looking at the new, the options, whether they're real options with people or finance options with new opportunities, but making sure there's a balance between the explore and the exploit.